Hey there, in this video we're covering the Flow Builder. Now hands down, this is one of the most unique and amazing things about ManyChat as a platform. It is my favorite element of the platform because you can do literally anything that you could possibly imagine and make it happen with the Flow Builder. From the automation side, the logic side, anything you want a user to experience or things you want to automate on the back end, they can all happen inside of the Flow Builder. So without further ado, let's just dive into it. Just overall, all of its really cool features that are very valuable and can save you a lot of time in the long run as well. So I'm inside of the Flows tab here in the left-hand column under Automation, and let's create a new flow together. When you create a new flow, you'll see a few different templates that are available for you to check out and just start with something so you're not starting from scratch. But since you're here, you may feel comfortable creating an empty flow and just playing around with it to get comfortable. I'm just gonna call this test. We're gonna create this, and you'll see that it is essentially different flowchart diagrams. And as you get a little bit crazier with this and add more and more to it, you'll see all of these different boxes leading to each other. And you'll also see how somebody would experience your flow, right? The chronological order in which somebody would go through that campaign, that use case, that conversation. So I'm here inside of the Flow Builder, and I can double tap over here anywhere in this gray area, which actually took me a long time to figure out, even though I've been using ManyChat almost since they got started. But you can double tap anywhere and create a new element. So you'll see all the different things that you can access here. If you're not quite sure what some of these are, no worries. We'll dive into them a little bit deeper later on. Or up here in the top right corner, when you click this blue plus sign, then you can also create any of these elements as well. So I'll stick with this easy one because as we're going, it's just easy to double tap and add more and more. And I'll create a Facebook message. So here, let's say something like, hi there, welcome to our Messenger bot. And right here under text, you'll notice that we can add different things like emojis. We can add custom fields, which are not only representing things that we get from Messenger, which I had mentioned in an earlier video, things like first name, last name, you know, when they were last seen here inside of the bot, their gender, time zone, the language that their Facebook profile is set to, which is really useful stuff, as well as fields that you can create for yourself to track the things that you want to. So I've created this text box, and then what I can do is send people over to, let's say, a next step. Now this next step could be text. It could also be things like, hey, I want to add a certain tag. So let's just add a test tag, right? And I want to track that somebody did something. Now, if I want to get even more crazy with it, we can add things like buttons. So I could say button one, click me, right? There's also things called quick replies. And the difference between these is that a button stays in the conversation while a quick reply will disappear after a user clicks one. So you might say something like quick reply one and quick reply two. And these can all lead to something different. So I might just create another message that says, you know, button one response. And then for quick reply number two, then I might have something else in here as well. And I can move these things around. You see how easy it is to just navigate this. And this starting step here, which we'll go over in another video, is essentially where the flow would actually begin. And you can move that around to different places within the conversation. And that's all. So I'm just gonna share with you a few other things in the next video because there is a lot to unpack here inside of the Flow Builder. But I believe that the best way that you can learn and understand how this feature works is to actually see it in action for specific examples. So for the rest of the course, there will be other instructors as well as myself walking you through examples for local businesses, for lead generation, for e-commerce, for infocommerce, for pretty much any business model and niche that you can imagine. We'll be trying to cover as much as we can. And so you'll see how these actual elements inside of the Flow Builder help support specific business use cases in that way. I'll see you in the next video.